Welcome everyone. In the previous classes, we have discussed why DNA is considered as the genetic material, because it is the one which is helping in the transformation. It is the one which is passing from one generation to another generation, or it is the one which is passing from one organism into another organism. Here, genetic material is DNA, not the protein. The material which is transformed or which is transferred is DNA, not the protein. This was already proved by Hershey and Chase. And now we know that DNA is the genetic material. And we have also know that RNA is also a genetic material. There are certain viruses, for example, TMV, tobacco mosaic virus. So that virus has RNA as the genetic material. So both this nucleic acid, that is DNA and RNA, both of them can act as the genetic material. Okay, so here, but DNA in most of the organisms, DNA is the predominant genetic material, whereas RNA is helping in the protein synthesis. Both of them can act as the genetic material. Both of them act as the genetic material. And we have also seen that there are many organisms which have DNA as the genetic material. There are few viruses which has RNA as the genetic material. But most predominant genetic material between these two, RNA and DNA, is DNA. DNA is the most predominant genetic material when compared with RNA. RNA, most of the time, it is helping in the protein synthesis. Why is it that DNA is the most predominant genetic material when compared to RNA? So, we'll see the differences between RNA and DNA, and then we will see why DNA is considered as the stable genetic material, why DNA is the predominant genetic material in most of the organisms, whereas RNA is acting as the protein, that is RNA is helping in the protein synthesis. So we will take out at the starting. Now we have seen that why, that is what are the conditions, what are the characteristics which should be there in the genetic material. If it is a genetic material, what are the characteristics it should possess? So we have already seen that if it is a genetic material, a material is said to be a genetic material when it is able to replicate itself, make copies, replicate in the sense make copies of itself. For example, if DNA is there, DNA should be able, for example, if this is one DNA, so this DNA should be able to make its copy, exact copy. If it is RNA, it should be able to make its exact copy. So that is what is replication. We said that is a nucleic acid. That is important characteristic when we can say that the substance is a nucleic acid. That substance or whatever the material it is, the chemical it is, it should be able to replicate itself. We know that DNA can also replicate itself as well as RNA can replicate itself. So they have, that is they both follow base pairing rule. This DNA as well as RNA, both of them follow base pairing rule. Okay, both of them follow complementarity. Base pairing rule in the sense adenine is there. If adenine is the near, that is nitrogenous base, it will always pairs with thymine. It will always pairs with thymine. And this one, if guanine is there, it will always pair with cytosine. If guanine is there, it will always pair with cytosine. If in case of this DNA, it is in case of DNA. In case of RNA, adenine always pairs with uracil. Adenine always pairs with uracil. Guanine always pairs with cytosine. So they follow, both of them, both this DNA as well as RNA, both follow both of them follow base pairing. Complementarity in the sense, for example, if there is two strands are separated, this if two strands were same, na, if two strands are separated, this is one and this is another. For example, if it is having A here, G here, C here, okay, T here, again C here. So if a new strand is formed, na, a new strand is formed, na, so they will be, it will be complementary to each other. If A is here, na, then the new strand will have, that is, it is able to replicate, na, it is able to produce a new one. It is able to produce a new one. When it produces new one, na, it is complementary in the sense, if A is there here, now on this strand, we will find T. On the strand, we'll find T. This is complementarity. If it is G here, na, on this pair, that is place of the strand, we find C. We find C. If C is there, then here we find G. If T is there, then here we find A. This strand is complementary. They can make, they will be able to, if there is only one strand, na, this DNA and RNA will be able to replicate itself. RNA will be able to replicate itself. If with one strand, na, another strand is made, a new strand is made, that will be complementary to the parent strand, or this is the template. The new strand will be complementary. If A is here, then it will, that is, on this place, you will always have thymine. So both this DNA as well as RNA, both follow base pairings, both follow, that is, both are, the, they both are, both follow base pairing and complementarity rules, and both of them are able to replicate itself. Replicate in the sense, they will be able to make the copies. If there is one DNA, na, they will be able to make more, many number of DNAs. If there is RNA, they will be able to make many number of RNAs. So here, they will be, first thing is, both of them can replicate itself. Both of them can replicate itself. And the second thing, here the most differences comes. We say na, genetic material, DNA is most predominant genetic material, where RNA is helping in the synthesis of protein. Why is it so? Main reason is this one. Main reason is this one. Nucleic acid should be stable. If the substance is acting as a nucleic acid, if a substance is acting as a nucleic acid, then that substance should be, say, stable. If it is a living organisms through various life cycles, various stages, okay, the various functions will be carrying out in our body, but every time, almost every time from birth to death, whatever function it is taking place inside the body, whatever the life stage which we are at, okay, whatever age we are at, the genetic material should be stable. It should not change. By birth, the genetic material was something different, that is, was some structurally different. By at the end, by when we age, it is different. It should not be like that. Throughout our life, throughout the life of the organism, the genetic material should be stable. The genetic material should be stable. Here comes in between, for the stability, here comes the differences. We have seen that there is differences in the structure of DNA and RNA. There is a little, very little difference in the structure of DNA and RNA. Here in DNA, if this is the, okay, this is the first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, and here we have fifth carbon. For RNA also the same. First, second, third, fourth, and this fifth. Here fifth will be attached to phosphate, first will be attached to nitrogenous base. Okay, it can be adenine or guanine. Here also it will be attached to phosphate, it will be attached to nitrogenous base. Okay, the difference, everything is the same here. The difference lies here. Here at this, in DNA, this at the second carbon we have an H, that is H group, whereas at third carbon we have OH group. There is only one OH functional group, whereas in RNA, on the second carbon also we have an OH group, and the third carbon also we have an OH group. This is the edge group, and here we have this OH. In DNA we have only one OH group, whereas in RNA we have two OH groups. This is OH functional group. More the functional group, more reactive it will become. So here, how many functional groups? That is OH is one. Here, two. So who is having more functional group? This is having more functional groups. So if it is having more functional group, means it will be more reactive. It will be more reactive. So less functional group, it will be less reactive. Okay, it is less reactive. And the thing is, if it is more reactive, means stability will be less. If it is reactive, means it is not stable. If it is reacting with one or the other, means it is not stable. It is not showing stability. So if it is more reactive, means it will be less stable. Okay, if it is less reactive, means it is showing, it is not reacting with, it is not showing that much reaction. So it is more stable. It is more stable. So here comes genetic material. If a substance is having the genetic material, it should be stable. It should be stable. That means it should be less reactive. Now you tell me which one is more stable and which one is less stable. Naturally, DNA is more stable because it is less reactive. RNA is less stable because it is more reactive. RNA is said to be catalytic as well. It is said to be catalytic. It speeds up reactions. It is said to be a catalytic. So first difference, why the genetic material, DNA is the prominent genetic material but not RNA. Here comes the difference. RNA is less stable, DNA is more stable. That is why DNA is the predominant, DNA is the better one. When compared to this one, DNA is the better one. So that is why DNA is the most predominant genetic material. If we take another also, we have seen this Griffith's experiment of transformation. So here, even after killing the bacteria, heat, with the help of the heat, the DNA was stable. DNA was stable even after heating that bacteria. Even after heating the bacteria, the DNA was stable. DNA was stable. So that is why here it is, DNA is more stable. So even when we may, that is by heating, if we separate the strands of DNA, these two strands, if we separate the strand by heating them, we can separate these two strands. Okay, so but when we, that when the, when proper conditions are given, when we stop heating them, they can again come and join. They can come again, come and join. For example, it was A here, T here on one strand, then here T A. So with the help of, because of the heat, these bonds were broken. Because of the heat, these bonds were broken and both strands separated. Okay, but when heat is, when we stop giving the heat, when the temperature is normal, when the conditions are normal, they again come and join together. So even heating, there is no change. Even after heating, there is no change in DNA. And DNA is less reactive. So that is why we consider DNA as the more stable one when compared to RNA. So that is why DNA is the most predominant genetic material. When coming to the third point, that is, genetic material should be able to show mutations. Both DNA and RNA, both of them show mutations. In fact, RNA shows rapid mutations, faster mutations when compared to DNA. But mutations means more changes. That is, changes. Change in the genetic material. So both of them will be able to show the mutations, both of them will be able to replicate, and both of them will express in the form of Mendelian characters. Both show expressions in the form of Mendelian characters. So that means it is forming, that is for this replication, for mutation, for this expression in the form of in Mendelian characters. So all the three are same, that is both of them are DNA follow replication as well as RNA. Mutations are seen in DNA as well as RNA. Both RNA and DNA, they express in the form of Mendelian characters. Okay, but the difference is in the stability. The difference is in the stability, because DNA is more stable. Because DNA is more stable, even after heating also there is no change in the DNA, and because of this presence of less functional group, that is only one OH group, and presence of two OH group in this RNA. So because of the presence of two OH group in RNA, RNA is more reactive and less stable. So when compared to this, see here, these three are the same in both. These three are the same in both. Both of them will be able to replicate. Both of them will show mutations. Both of them will express the characters, Mendelian, in the form of Mendelian characters. So everything, these three things are same in both DNA and RNA. But the thing which makes the difference, why DNA is good, why is DNA is good, and why DNA is considered as the genetic material, and why RNA is not considered as the genetic material, the difference here is in the stability. Because of the functional group, less functional group in DNA, it is more stable and less reactive, and even after heating also there is no change in the DNA. So that is why DNA is considered as the predominant and the most favorable genetic material. So that is why it is predominant in most of the living organisms. So this was the basic differences which were there in DNA and RNA, as so that DNA and RNA. So basically DNA is the predominant genetic material in all the living organisms, and RNA will be helping in the synthesis of proteins. RNA will be helping in the synthesis of proteins.